Chapter 4 Bulls, Cows, Pigs, etc. From the Hebrides there comes to me a case of the phantasm of a black bull that, on certain nights in the year, is heard bellowing inside the shed where it was killed. There are many accounts of ghostly cows heard mooing in the moors and boglands of Scotland and Ireland respectively, and not a few cases of whole herds of phantom cattle seen, gliding along, one behind the other, with silent, noiseless tread. Though I have never had the opportunity of experimenting with cows to see if they are sensitive to the superphysical, I see no reason why they should not be, and I feel quite certain they will participate in the future life. Apropos of pigs, Mr. Dyer, in his Ghost World, says, Another form of spectre animal is the Kirk Grim, which is believed to haunt many churches. Sometimes it is a pig, sometimes a horse. The haunting spectre being the spirit of an animal buried alive in the churchyard for the purpose of scaring away the sacrilegious. Mr. Dyer goes on to say that it was the custom of the old Christian churches to bury a lamb under the altar, and that if anyone entered a church out of service time and happened to see a little lamb spring across the choir and vanish, it was a sure prognostication of the death of some child. And if this apparition was seen by the grave digger, the death would take place immediately. Mr. Dyer also tells us that the Danish Kirk Grim was thought to hide itself in the tower of a church in preference to any other place, and that it was thought to protect the sacred buildings. According to the same writer, in the streets of Krosterburg, a grave sow, or, as it was called, a grey sow, was frequently seen, and it was said to be the apparition of a sow formerly buried alive, its appearance foretelling death or calamity. Phantasm of a Goat. Mrs. Crowe, in her Night Side of Nature, relates one case of a house near Philadelphia, USA, that was haunted by a variety of phenomena, among others, that of a specter resembling a goat. Other extraordinary things happened in the house, she writes, which had the reputation of being haunted, although the son had not believed it, and had thereupon not mentioned the report to the father. One day, the children said they had been running after such a queer thing in the cellar. It was like a goat, and not like a goat, but it seemed to be like a shadow. This explanation does not appear to be very satisfactory, but as I have heard of one or two other cases of premises being haunted by what, undoubtedly, were the phantasms of goats, I think it highly probable it was the ghost of a goat in this instance, too. The Phantom Pigs of Chiltern Hills. A good many years ago, there was a story current of an extraordinary haunting by a herd of pigs. The chief authority on the subject was a farmer, who was an eyewitness of the phenomena. I will call him Mr. B. Mr. B., as a boy, lived in a small house called the Moat Grange, which was situated in a very lonely spot near four crossroads, connecting four towns. The house, deriving its name from the fact that a moat surrounded it, stood near the meeting point of the four roads, which was the site of a gibbet, the bodies of the criminals being buried in the moat. Well, the bees had not been living long on the farm before they were awakened one night by hearing the most dreadful noises, partly human and partly animal, seemingly proceeding from a neighboring spinney, and on going to a long front window overlooking the crossroads, they saw a number of spotted creatures like pigs, screaming, fighting, and tearing up the soil on the site of the criminal's cemetery. The sight was so unexpected and alarming that the bees were appalled, and Mr. B. was about to strike a light on the tinderbox when the most diabolical white face was pressed against the outside of the window pane and stared in at them. This was the climax. The children shrieked with terror, and Mrs. B., falling on her knees, began to pray, whereupon the face at the window vanished, and the herd of pigs, ceasing their disturbance, tore frantically down one of the high roads and disappeared from view. Similar phenomena were seen and heard so frequently afterwards that the bees eventually had to leave the farm, and subsequent inquiries led to their learning that the place had long borne the reputation of being haunted, the ghosts being supposed to be the earthbound spirits of the executed criminals. Whether this was so or not must, of course, be a matter of conjecture. The herds of hogs may well have been the phantasms of actual earthbound pigs, attracted to the spot by a sort of fellow feeling for the criminals, whose gross and carnal natures would no doubt appeal to them. A lane in Hertfordshire was, and perhaps still is, haunted by the phantasm of a big white sow which had accidentally been run over and killed. It was occasionally heard grunting, and had the unpleasant knack of approaching one noiselessly from the rear, and of making the most unearthly noise just behind one's back. Sheep. Lambs and sheep, possessing finer natures than goats and pigs, would appear to be less earthbound, and, in all probability, only temporarily haunt the spots that witnessed their usually barbarous ends. Most slaughter horses are haunted by them, as indeed by many other animals. A Scottish moor long bore the reputation for being haunted by a phantom flock of sheep, which were always heard baaing plaintively before a big storm. It was supposed they were the ghosts of a flock that had perished in the memorable severe weather of Christmas 1880. Here is a case that may be regarded as typical of hauntings by sheep. Presumably, the earthbound spirits of the sheep, overwhelmed in some great storm or unexpected catastrophe. The Spectre Flock of Sheep in Germany. During the 7 years' war in Germany, writes Mrs. Crowe in her Night Side of Nature, a drover lost his life in a drunken squabble on the high road. For some time, there was a sort of rude tombstone, with a cross on it, to mark the spot where his body was interred. But this has long fallen, and a milestone now fills its place. Nevertheless, it continues to be commonly asserted by the country people, and also by various travelers, that they may have been deluded on that spot by seeing, as they imagine, herds of beasts, which, on investigation, proved to be merely visionary. Of course, many people look upon this as a superstition, but a very regular confirmation of the story occurred in the year of 1826, when two gentlemen and two ladies were passing the spot in a post carriage. One of these was a clergyman, and none of them had ever heard of the phenomenon said to be attached to the place. They had been discussing the prospects of the minister, who was on his way to a vicarage to which he had just been appointed, when they saw a large flock of sheep, which stretched quite across the road, and was accompanied by a shepherd and a long-haired black dog. As to meet cattle on that road was nothing uncommon, and indeed they had met several droves in the course of one day. No remark was made at the moment, till suddenly they looked at each other and said, "What's become of the sheep?" Quite perplexed at their sudden disappearance, they called to the position to stop, and all got out, in order to mount the little elevation and look around, but still unable to discover them, they now bethought themselves of asking the postillion where they were, when, to their infinite surprise, they learned that he had not seen them. Upon this, they bade him quicken his pace, that they might overtake a carriage that had passed them shortly before, and inquire if that party had seen the sheep. But they had not. 4 years later, a postmaster named Jay was on the same road driving a carriage, in which were a clergyman and his wife, when he saw a large flock of sheep near the same spot. Seeing they were very fine wethers, and supposing them to have been bought at a sheep fair that was taking place a few miles off, Jay drew up his reins and stopped his horses, turning at the same time to the clergyman to say that he wanted to inquire the price of the sheep, as he intended going the next day to the fair himself. Whilst the minister was asking him what sheep he meant, Jay got down and found himself in the midst of the animals, the size and beauty of which astonished him. They passed him at an unusual rate, whilst he made his way through them to find the shepherd, when, on getting to the end of the flock, they suddenly disappeared. He then first learned that his fellow travelers had not seen them at all. So writes Mrs. Crowe, and I quote the case in support of my argument that sheep, like horses, cats, dogs, and all other kinds of animals, possess spirits, and consequently have a future state of existence. I have not yet experimented with sheep, goats, or pigs, but I do not doubt that they are more or less sensitive to the superphysical influences, and possess the psychic faculty of scenting the unknown, though not, perhaps, in so great a degree as any of the other animals I have enumerated. End of chapter 4.